Hello, welcome back to one of my favorite games of 2022. As you can see, everything is very nice and festive. Now, well, I'm actually surprised. Everything is very nice. No monstrosities, no nothing. Look at the Christmas decorations. And even this guy, Alfred, is wearing a hat. So cute. So, what's the big update? This is a major update. And to be honest, if the game was released in the state that it's currently right now, the game would have been a massive hit with people playing it for, I don't know, hundreds of hours, thousands of players every day. I think the problem with the game was not necessarily related to the game itself, was probably related to the gaming industry itself. It lacked the mass media appearance, well, gaming mass media appearance that probably other games would have had for free. I guess it didn't appeal to many people because it's a hardcore game and also it's... How should I put it? It's one of those games that doesn't fit one genre. When I first started playing the game, I didn't even read anything about it. I didn't know it was PvP, I didn't know it was extraction based, I didn't know anything. I just looked at some screenshots, a little bit of a video, and then I played it. So, if you want to recommend the game to someone, don't tell them anything about the game. Well, maybe it's PvP, and that's about it. And let them kind of explore the game. Now, the game had a huge update and I'll talk about these things in a bit. But first of all, the major thing is that now we have a referral code. Now, if you want, you can copy my referral code. Oh, wow, I cannot. Well, I can copy to the clipboard. I'll just put it in the comments, pinned in the comments. There are a few rules for this. No players that started playing the game at release can use the codes. So for example, if I started playing before 22 December, I can only give codes, but I cannot accept codes. So if you started playing after 22 December, you'll have here something that will allow you to redeem the codes. But I guess that makes all of the people who played before 22 December referral code givers. And the ones that are playing after 22 are referral code takers, but also givers. So I'll just put it in the comment if you want to get some free stuff, and I think I'll get some free stuff as well, but a little bit later. I think you can only introduce the code after you play the tutorial. And it's a nice system, I guess. Let me see what the price for the game is currently. So the price for the game is about... €11. Full price is 15, so it's always going to be cheap or nice. Now, let's get into the big updates. Now, first of all, I just want to mention a few things. short version of the update list, because we have a lot of things to go through. Let me read a little bit from the... Okay, so new Winter Hell E-Day event, new enemies, new devices, durability and pocket and fixes. Probably the major update and probably the one that people will not agree with is that now weapons have durability. And it ties into the game's general theme. So as you can see, you can no longer use weapons for your eternity. Now you have to use them and then just throw away them. You can still use them for quests. For example, if you have a 0% weapon, you can still give it to a quest. Because it doesn't matter, but if they reach 0%, I think they stop working. I'm not sure how this works. It might be related to after you finish the raid. So I don't think it will stop working during the raid. I think it only stop working after a raid or something. Depends on other things. I'll have to test this thing out a lot because they don't specify a lot of things. Also, now we have the pocket. What is the pocket? Well, the pocket is simply a place for you to put an item that is safe. Which, to be honest, it's great news. Because you're supposed to take a lot of things out of your pocket. I think the developers intended for you to go into a raid and then, for example, get a baseball bat, come back with it and then give it to a quest next time. But I think most people just put all of their money inside the pocket and then take it to the bank, which will mean a lot more people will have access to things to buy. Which is great, because this way everyone can just put all of their money in the bank and just safely buy everything they need. Well, I say safely, but nothing is 100% safe, but at least it will be 95% safe. This also works for weapons. I'm not sure if you can put your weapon in the middle of combat in there. There are specific rules to the pocket. And let me read you some of the news. About the pocket. Because, okay, safe pocket. So they're not lootable by other players. The pocket items in the pocket cannot be equipped, so they don't appear in any selection wheel. Okay, so they don't appear in the selection wheel. And if all of your slots are used up, you can put it in the pocket. For example, you can put a spray, a deodorant in the pocket. They don't specific. Okay, they don't say a lot of things, so I'll assume you can just put your money in here and then you go to the bank and put it from the pocket into the bank itself. Oh, I think we'll test it out this time. As for durability, firearms have a degradation per shot. Melee weapon has a degradation per hit. It decreases linearly based on its durability. So the weapon's value... Okay, so the more you use it, the less it will be worth. So we'll not sell it for full price. For example, they give you this amount of money. For durability, 75. Oh, I guess they don't show you that. Okay, they don't specify that. But the stats will be the same, even if it's very, very low durability. Yeah, nothing changes. The stats don't change, but at zero, you cannot use it anymore. So again, they're not very clear on what they mean by a lot of things. So I guess we'll have to test out some of them and see. So that's the pocket and the durability. The new devices. The new devices are the one that actually interests me the most. The new devices are basically utility items or grenades, bear traps, glue traps and stuff like that. Flashbang. The flashbang does exactly what you think it does. Well, I guess I should go out in the hallway. This is better conversation space. Flashbang will blind you and probably deafen you as well, so you cannot hear and cannot see for a limited amount of time. This is great for, you know, when you are attacking someone or if you want to run away. The bear trap. The bear trap will basically stop an enemy in his tracks. For example, you go out a window and then put a bear trap and then someone follows you. That enemy will be stuck to the ground, so I think it also inflicts bleeding damage, but I'm not sure. Again, it doesn't specify a lot of things. From what I see from the video, it just traps someone in place. So it might just be trapping them in place, no damage. Smoke grenade. Smoke grenade is actually amazing because if you use the smoke grenade, nobody will be able to see you in the smoke while you extract. So I guess it's very good for elevators, molotov, yeah, area. An area is covered with fire, so it's damage over time. And if someone steps in it, he'll receive damage over time as well. Glue grenade is just a slow grenade if someone steps on it, and I guess you can toss it in front of someone so they cannot run away from you. Claymore is basically a mine that has a laser trigger in a huge area, so you have to be a lot more careful with it. Kind of put it at the outside of a building, so if they trip the claymore, it will have a huge range of explosion, but it will also mean that they don't have to be near it to explode, just they have to cross the laser. I'll have to see if I can play with that a little bit, because it's not very clear how it works. What about the holiday? Well, the holiday, as you can see, is the decorations, but also we have some new furniture. It's basically some French-looking furniture with French names and French smell to them. And yeah, it's probably going to be fine. So the referral system, new enemies. Oh yeah, new enemies. The new enemies are basically two varieties. So now you have the normal enemies, which are nerfed, and then you have the tier 2 enemies of the same kind, or the level 2 enemies. Those are a little different. Sometimes, for example, an enemy can make you bleed, an enemy can make you blind, an enemy can have a lot of other effects, so including other attacks. So a tier 1 enemy, let's say the little guy that explodes, it's the same except a little weaker. The tier 2 guy, for example, will follow you if you step in it. And it might explode and kill you, so that's bad. For example, the bug that shoots stuff at you, it's now a little weaker, but the stuff that it shoots at you, it will blind you. So I guess if you look at the head of the enemy, you'll see a different I don't know, it's kind of like the red eyes from Dark and Darker, probably. Or the red tone of the enemy to kind of present it's more dangerous. So yeah, huge updates, I love it. Let me see what my quests are. We'll play a little bit, Paltry and Waging Thing. Still playing on North America. I think the game is perfect right now. I don't think it needs anything else. Of course, more content would be nice, but I think now they can focus on just doing more events and doing more stuff for players. I don't think any other company in the industry, or at least the indie game industry, has focused so much on getting new players to the game. I mean, they have everything now. They have streamer drops, they have Twitch integration, they have referral codes. They also have a lot of discounts. And they also basically sell the game for very cheap. I guess maybe people don't like the PvP aspect of the game and they'll like a PvE one, but I think the developers could make a PvE map that lacks most of the quest. I don't know, maybe I'll suggest that on the on their forums. A PvE map where people get half of the experience for extracting, where they will find a very, very limited array of items, for example, mostly food or stuff that they cannot really use, no pills, some mushrooms here and there. It might be an idea. I think that would work. Because sometimes you just don't want to do PvP, because, I don't know, you want to relax, you are tired, you are sleepy, you want to play a short game with not much of a risk or lose. I'm very worried about one thing though. That means automatics are very bad if you have weapon degradation per bullet shot. Probably if you empty the magazine from this one, 50 bullets, it will probably drop 10% in durability or something like that, I don't know, or at least that's what I imagine. So it might be better to just use pistols or single-shot weapons, but that means, well, I guess they need to introduce some single-shot weapons. The shotguns were nerfed very much, so now they work exactly as intended. But I guess with the bear traps, the glue grenades, the flashbangs, and the other stuff, it will be much harder for people to play with the shotguns now. Ah, let's see. Let's try taking my money to the bank. Wait, did I deposit them? Yeah. Okay, that's actually amazing. So it works as intended. I don't think the developers wanted people to do this. Because it eliminates all risks involved in carrying money with you. But like I said, I will not be upset about it. I think someone said you always find jewelry over here, but apparently not. Well, that was not mine. Oh! Scared me. Oh, it's the new variety. Look at it. Look at it and marvel at its beauty. As you can see, they have different graphic style. Their head looks a little different. And you do get more creds for killing them. Okay. I don't feel like fighting. Okay, so items don't... Oh, I guess that's not so bad if you have to drag your money in there. I might also be using a deodorant. Oh, that was the exploding one. Ah. Yeah, it's a little harder for me to see what they are. That can get a little bit annoying. I'm not used to the new one, so I guess I have to... Well, I guess I'm not very... very warmed up either. I didn't play before recording the video. I forgot that was... the exploding one. Somebody wants to eat me. Again. Oh, that's kind of bad if you can find weapons that are so badly damaged. Smoke grenade, really? Am I slowed down? I think I'm slowed down. Yeah, so I guess that one will slow you down when it damages you. What are you, little thing? It was so fast. Yeah, these new enemies are skilled. The PvE is a lot stronger now. Yeah, I think I'll just leave. Oh, the bear trap. Yeah, it also bleeds and it blocks for 2 seconds. I guess that means immobilizes someone for 2 seconds, not blocks. Overall, very good changes, but I feel like the developers didn't really think this through because I'm a Escape from Tarkov player. As you can see, I already use things differently than the developers wanted or intended. So that basically means I can take all of my money to the bank. In a way, it's good because it frees up a lot of your slots from the apartment. I no longer have to use free slots to keep my money. I can just, you know, play 2 or 3 games, put the money in the bank, and then buy all the furniture I want. So that means now I can really, really focus on getting items so I can sell today, this day. Again, I don't think that was the intention of the developers, but it does speed up the game because beforehand you could play the game for what? 20 hours and make zero progress almost? Because you do some quests but you wouldn't get money, so I guess this means now you don't have to choose between money, progress, quests, getting buff items. Yeah, they actually lose quite a bit of durability. Not sure how many times I hit the enemy. Let's just say it's 20 times. I guess they don't lose so much durability. What am I thinking of? So I guess the weapons themselves don't lose too much durability. I fired a few bullets, I didn't lose anything. Okay, so you can double click it only if you don't have any more slots. And then it will go into the secret pocket. Yeah, I guess the game really needed something like this. The developers... Oh wow, it's giving me all of the bad stuff. Don't tempt me, game. Oh, the bear trap is huge. You'll see it from a mile away. That is if you're not running. So yeah, I guess the developers made the game a lot more fluent. Yeah. And that's the Molotov. Well, to be honest, I think we can throw it. Because I'm very curious of one thing. That scared me. I saw the spots and I thought there was something out there. Huh. That's actually great because you create kind of like a fire pit and even enemies. Well, I guess the AI doesn't know to avoid the flames, so it steps right into them, which might be a problem. Ah, I didn't jump enough. And actually give a lot of blood now, weirdly enough. I'm too greedy, I might die. Okay, I'll keep quiet for a few moments. Yeah, great changes, because I remember when playing in the beginning, it was very hard to make progress, especially before you get so many inventory slots. But now with the secret pocket, you can actually make progress so much faster. I cannot believe how different the game is right now. Well, at least in terms of progress. You cannot see anything in the cloud. Plus it makes noise. That's great. So these utility items are really utility items because you can find them pretty easy. So I think everyone will be able to use them if they have time. I mean, I think I found almost all of them except for the flashbang and the glue grenade. That was actually super nice. I think that's something for the holiday. 2100. Let me see what happens if I sell stuff. How much money did I make? I think I made a lot of money this raid. Oh yeah, 11,000. 14,000. Okay. So many good changes. This mesh tree. Okay. I almost wanted to sing something nice. Now they better not take away the Christmas tree from me. Well, I wanted to put it over there, but I guess it's not possible. Ah, I want it. I wanted to put it over here, but it doesn't have room apparently. Oh well. Well, I guess you can. The video is pretty much over. I'm just trying to see some things. Oh, it overlaps with the light, so let's put the... so close, yet so far away. On the other hand, do I need extra storage space? Probably I do. Probably I do need the extra storage space, but as you can see, I can clear out the money stuff now. So next time I go to the in a mission, I'll have all of that money to deposit at the bank. Yeah, it's a great update. So is this enough? No. Well, I do need a planter if I only have one plant, right? I can put the shelf over there. And maybe I can put this somewhere else. Why is item management so annoying? Okay, it's enough. Okay, so I have the Halloween decoration and also the Christmas decoration, but this, the Christmas tree is just too nice. I like the game, I like the game very much now. Look at this, isn't this very festive atmosphere? See you next time, bye.